All right. Thank you, children and children's leaders, for helping out today and leading us in worship. And we had 120 in Sunday school today. So we're thankful for everyone that came, and we're looking forward to a brand new church year that's going to be starting in September. And just want to remind you that business meeting Wednesday night, we've got a lot of business to transact, so we encourage you to be here for that. We're going to be approving the slate of officers and teachers for our next year, so we're looking forward to sharing in that. We want to remind our deacons and Baptist women, you're meeting Monday night, and then Tuesday night we have Rock and CCC, if it doesn't rain, but there's a lot of rain in the forecast, so we'll kind of see what's going to happen. And it wasn't put on the calendar here, but Youth Council's meeting this Wednesday night at 7:45. And then we've got a church-wide trip to Chuckles in Crossville, noon on Saturday. Looking forward to sharing with that. And also want to remind you that next Sunday we'll be having a special offering for the building fund. And we do this in April and in August and in November. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to get to the point where we have paid off $400,000. And so hopefully we'll do that in the next month or so. So we have a lot going on, and we appreciate so much your prayers, participation. Also, just want to remind you that if you're visiting with us the first time, we'd love to have a record of your visit. There should be a visitor's card or a guest card in the pocket in front of you, in the chair in front of you there. If you could fill that out, we would greatly appreciate it. And also, if you'll notice in the bulletin, August 12th marks 5 years that Christopher Giles has served as our worship leader. And so, Christopher, if you'd come, please. I got a presentation I want to make to you. And just want to let you know that we appreciate your enthusiasm and your commitment. And I know that whenever we have the Christmas music, I always participate and always enjoy being a part of that. And I hope that in the next few days, if you haven't done so already, I hope that you will take the opportunity to just thank Christopher for his service, because there's a lot of hours that are involved in it. It's not just on Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, but there's a lot of work that goes into selecting the music. And I get to present to you a gift from the church, and as a way of saying thank you for your service. Okay. Okay. As we go, Lord, in prayer, there's some folks that I would like to mention that we need to be in prayer for. Let's be in prayer for Shirley Jones, who is over at the Oak Ridge Hospital. Also learned that Ronnie Trout's mother, June, is over there at the hospital. And then we need to pray for two of our members who are over at the Life Care Center right now, who are involved in rehab, and that is Dave Comfort and Reese Langley. So please remember those folks in your prayers. Good to see you here today, and let's start out with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for all the blessings that you give to us, and we just pray as we gather here this morning that you would just touch our hearts with your love. Lord, help us that today that we can receive some type of blessing or direction or hope or whatever need that we have, that you could give that to us, Heavenly Father. And we're so thankful that today that we can just celebrate the 5 years that Christopher has served here on our church staff. And we pray that you'll continue to bless his work in our midst. And Lord, help us always to celebrate your name and to celebrate the many blessings you have given to us. We pray for these that are in the hospital or in rehab, Heavenly Father. We pray your blessings upon them and healing. And we also pray, Heavenly Father, you'll be with their families, because we know that these can be trying times, and we ask your blessings upon them. Thank you for forgiveness of our sins. Thank you for allowing us to live in America where we can worship freely. And so touch our hearts today, and it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. And I just want to say thank you to each and every one of you for your prayers for me as I lead our music program here at Liberty. I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for giving me the opportunity to serve here on staff at Liberty, and more so to give me the opportunity that I can use my job here to share my faith with those that I encounter in my day-to-day life, because it's okay to say, oh, by the way, I'm on staff at a church. By the way, here's the kind of church we go to, and here's a little bit about what we believe, and I thank you for giving me that opportunity. Also, I can't do what I do all by myself, and I am indebted to our musicians that play each and every Sunday, to our sound and audio video technicians, and mostly for the choir who sings every Sunday, and I just ask that you give them a big hand. And finally, to you, the congregation, who gets to sing every Sunday morning, let's stand as we all sing together hymn number 615, When the Morning Comes. Understand it better by and by. And you wondered why you couldn't hear me. You thought, boy, this is going to be a wonderful anniversary, five-year anniversary gift. We don't have to listen to him. Turn over to hymn number 239. 239, The Wonderful Cross. Sorrow Someone around you this morning.